This is a soundbite budget crafted by Governor Corbett that will hurt middle-class families. This is a budget that is a direct result of a campaign promise to a Washington, D.C. lobbyist, and we all know that is why we are in the position we are in today, where we are going to have a budget vote on a proposal that is so bad for middle-class families and for public education. We have a $700 million surplus sitting in the state treasury right now, and we are the only state in the nation that does not tax Marcellus Shale natural gas drilling. This includes George Bush's Texas, Sarah Palin's Alaska, and Dick Cheney's Wyoming. Now, I do recognize that this budget will be on time. Our kids on a school night have a bedtime that they have to meet, and they also have chores to get done before they get to bed. And so when we go up at 9 o'clock to tuck them in and kiss them goodnight, and sometimes we notice the shoes are all messed up in the closet, sometimes the homework isn't done just right, sometimes the book bag is flailing away and the clothes aren't put in the hamper right. And I say, what happened? You didn't get your chores done. Hey, but Dad, it's 9 o'clock, I'm in bed. I'm at my bedtime. Well, that's what this budget is. It's on time, but all of the other responsibilities are not being met. What are some of those responsibilities? Governor Corbett's cuts that will increase local school property taxes. York City, 5.2% as a result of this budget. Governor Corbett's cuts that will increase class sizes all across Pennsylvania. York City class sizes will nearly double as a result of this budget. In fact, York City's per student cut is the third highest per student cut of the 500 school districts in Pennsylvania. Governor Corbett's cuts, the 10% cut to the Department of Environmental Protection, will lead, we all know it, will lead to more pollution. Governor Corbett's cuts will also lead to more structurally deficient bridges, which Pennsylvania already leads the nation in. Governor Corbett's cuts have already resulted in the elimination of the Adult Basic Program, which is hurting working families all across Pennsylvania. And this budget will also lead to job losses in the tens of thousands across Pennsylvania. Governor Corbett's budget also specifically hurts our hospitals. York Hospital, Memorial Hospital in the 95th Legislative District will be hurt by this budget. Not only will That will also happen all over Pennsylvania. And the community college cuts will also hurt, especially our working families of Pennsylvania, because with the rising tuition in so many of our colleges, so many of those families are then trying to get into community colleges, not only the Harrisburg Area Community College, your campus, but community colleges all over Pennsylvania will be hurt. This also does not make strategic sense. We know that to win the future, you have to win the education battle. You have to have an educated workforce. And many of our employers, they are going to be seeking out the most qualified workers regardless of where they come from. We are not just competing with other states anymore, we're competing with other nations. India, China, they are doubling down on their investment in education, looking to beat us in the future. And if we do not have the workforce to compete with them, our kids and our businesses will be at a competitive disadvantage. To win the future and fight for the middle class, I ask for a no vote on the Corbett budget. Thank you, Mr. Speaker.